वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडेज टॉपिक इज वॉटर. सो वॉटर इज अ प्रीशियस नैचुरल रिसोर्स. ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स नीड वॉटर फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल. वी कैनॉट इमेजिन लाइफ विदाउट वॉटर. लेट इट बी एनिमल्स और प्लांट्स, दे रिक्वायर वॉटर टू कंप्लीट देयर डेली मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटीज. प्लांट्स रिक्वायर वॉटर to synthesize the food from the process of photosynthesis. On average, an individual uses 600 to 700 liters in a day. We all can live without food for days together, but cannot even imagine surviving without water. Even plants become dry and shed their leaves without water. So here water means it is a colorless and transparent chemical substance which is the main constituent of streams, oceans, lakes on earth crust. It is an important fluid that play a significant role in sustaining life on earth. The chemical formula of water is H2O. It is made up of two components. One is a hydrogen atom and another one is a oxygen, and it is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom which are held together by a covalent bonds. 71% of Earth's surface is made up of this liquid. So here, what are the physical and chemical properties of water? One is it is a colorless and a tasteless liquid. Compared to other liquids, it has a higher thermal conductivity, specific heat, surface tension, etc. Water is referred as a universal solvent, as most substances such as acids, salts, sugar and gases readily dissolve in it. Water has the capability to form azeotropes with other solvents. The electrical conductivity of water is low. However, it can be improved by adding ionic substances that dissociate to give ions in the aqueous phase for carrying the charge. So again, here water is of three forms, nothing but here states of water. So pure water is tasteless, odorless and colorless. Water occur in three states here. One is solid, liquid and gases. So solid water, nothing but ice is frozen water. So when water freezes, its molecules move farther apart, making ice less dense than water. This means that ice will be lighter than the same volume of water, and so ice will float in water, and water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So a liquid water, another state, and it is a wet and a fluid. It is the form of water in which we are most familiar. We use liquid water in many ways, including washing and drinking. And the third form is as a gaseous. Vapor is always present in the air around us, so we cannot see it. So when you boil water, the water charges from a liquid to the gaseous or water vapor. As some of the water vapor cools, we see it as a small cloud called steam. This cloud of steam is a main version of the clouds we see in the sky. At sea level, steam is formed at 100 degrees Celsius and at 212 degrees Fahrenheit. So here the water vapor attaches to small bits of dust in the air. It forms raindrops in a warm temperatures. So in cloud temperatures, it freezes and forms snow. So what are the importance of water first used for agriculture purpose. The most important use of water is for agriculture. Irrigation is necessary for agriculture, and for that water is the key point to produce food and for drinking. And another important, right, the human body contains 50 to 78% of water according to the size of the body. So humans need to drink 7 liters of water every day to avoid dehydration. If less amount of water is present, then it is nothing but a dehydration. So next, health. It plays important role in digestion and other biological process that occur in a living organisms. It plays an important role in maintaining the pH of the body. It also helps the movement of antibodies from the immune system. Next, regulator. It also acts as, it helps in regulating the body temperature. Water provides the necessary cooling effect to the body. And intoxication. Water removes harmful toxins from the body through precipitation and urination. So it prevents to the buildup of wastes in the living organism. Next, we use water for washing. It is used to make emulsions and solutions which are used for washing purposes. So these are the main importance of water here. Next, we study about precipitation. You already heard the word about precipitation, right? So precipitation is a process by which all forms of water reach back to earth from the atmosphere. Precipitation occurs in the form of rainfall, frost, hail and dew. Among all, rainfall and snowfall contribute a significant amount of water. So in water resource study, precipitation is commonly condensed as a rainfall, as it is one of the major sources of water coming to earth. The forms, types and features of precipitation are briefly explained here. So one by one we are going to see here. Forms of precipitation. So here first is a rain. Rain is a form of precipitation that is in the form of water drops of a size larger than 0.5 millimeter. The maximum raindrop size is about 6 millimeter. Drops of larger size breaks up into smaller droplets as it fall down. Rainfall is the predominant form of precipitation, and hence the term precipitation is used synonymously with a rainfall here. The magnitude of a rainfall shows high temporal and spatial variation. This variation is responsible for the occurrence of hydraulic extremes such as floods and droughts. Next form of precipitation is a snow. Snow consists of ice crystals in a flaky form. That is, average density is 0.1 glacier degree Celsius. And it is also an important form of precipitation here. Next, third is a drills. So here, drills is a fine sprinkle of tiny water droplets of size less than 0.5 millimeter and intensity greater than 1 millimeter per height. So here the tiny droplets from forming a drills appear to float in air. Next is a freezing rain or a glaze. The glaze is formed when rain or a drizzle comes in contact with the cold ground at around 0 degrees Celsius. The water drops freeze to form as ice coating. Next, a slit. Slit is a frozen raindrops formed when rainfall passes through the air at a sub-freezing temperature. Next is a hail. So hail is a type of showery precipitation in the form of pellets or a lumps of a size greater than 8 millimeter. Hail occurs in a violent thunderstorms. So these are a few forms of a precipitation. Next, types of precipitation. So here precipitation occurs when the moist air mass undergoes condensation. This process happens when the air is cooled and saturated with the same amount of moisture. So this process of cooling air mass is performed only when the air mass moves up to higher altitudes. The air mass can be lifted to higher altitudes mainly by three methods, based on which there are three types of precipitation, namely cyclonic precipitation, convective precipitation, and orographic precipitation. So cyclonic precipitation, here a cyclone is a region in which atmosphere with large low pressure having circular wind motion. The cyclonic precipitation is caused by the movement of moist air mass to this region due to the difference in pressure. Cyclones can be of two forms, frontal and non-frontal precipitation. So frontal precipitation is called as the hot moist air mass boundary. This precipitation is caused by the expansion of air near the frontal surface. So non-frontal precipitation, this is the cold moist air mass boundary that move and results in precipitation. Next, second form is a convective type. So the air above the land area gets heated up by some cause. The most warmer air rises up and cools and precipitates. So convective precipitation is a showery in nature. This type of precipitation happens in varying intensities. So the aerial extent of convective precipitation is small, in a range of less than 10 kilometer in diameter. Organographic precipitation. Moving air masses have chance to strike barriers like mountains. Once they strike, they rise up, which causes condensation and precipitation. The precipitation is greater in the windward side of the barrier compared to the leeward side of the barrier. So here you can see the types of rainfall and their intensity. So light rainfall, moderate and heavy, right? And the, in the light rainfall, the intensity traces about 2.5 millimeter, and in moderate it is about 2.5 to 7.5, but in heavy moderate it is greater than 7.5 here. So occurrence of precipitation, precipitation occurs when the atmosphere has sufficient moisture. There must be a sufficient nuclei, that is nothing but a salt particles, products of combustion, etc. In the atmosphere, to make condensation happen, weather conditions must be favorable for the condensation of water vapor to take place. So here, under favorable weather conditions, water vapor condenses over these nuclei to form tiny water droplets of size generally less than 0.1 millimeter in diameter. The clouds are carried by the wind, while its turbulence helps to retain water droplets in suspension, similar to the particles in a colloidal suspension. So here precipitation occurs when these water droplets come together and collide, forming large droplets of water that can drop down. When the precipitation occurs, a considerable part of it evaporates back into the atmosphere. So net precipitation at a place and its form depend on the number of meteorological factors such as temperature, humidity, wind, pressure in the region, right? So these are the occurrence of precipitation, where they occur. So by this session we studied about what is water and their importance, states of water and the precipitation, types of precipitation, occurrence of precipitation and forms of precipitation. Okay, thank you.